şansı var. Gelsin işte.
Will everyone please rise? You may be seated. Welcome, family and friends. Matt and Jackie have chosen to openly declare their love for each other and celebrate their happiness before you, their closest family and friends. You are an integral part of their day-to-day being. You are the loving and supportive community that strengthens their lives. Jackie and Matt are very pleased that you're here to share this important occasion with them. Jackie and Matt, as you join yourselves in marriage, there is a vast future stretching out before you. The possibilities and promise of your married life are great, and now together you will walk the path that will make your dreams real. Through your commitment to each other, may you grow and nurture a love that makes both of you better people, a love that continues to give you great joy, and a passion for living that provides you with energy and patience to face the responsibilities of life. The essence of this commitment is the honoring of another person in their entirety as a life partner, heart companion, and soul friend. It is therefore a decision which is undertaken with great consideration and respect. Make such a decision and keep on making it, for the most important thing in life is to love and to be loved in return. Jacqueline Diana Mablem and Matthew Thomas Nelson Grove, do you come to this union with a sincere desire to join your lives together?
I do.
We do.
I've never met a father who is willing to give up his daughter, so instead I will ask, who opens their hearts to bring this man into their family and give your blessing to this marriage?
Her mother and I, on behalf of everybody that loves Jackie and Matt, we all do.
Thank you. Put your hands together. Thank you. You may be seated. This ceremony is an opportunity for Jackie and Matt to celebrate their love and to honor everyone who has added so much to their lives. I would like Matt and Jackie to take a moment now to turn and look out over the faces of everyone that have joined together today to celebrate them and their love. As their witnesses, you have the privilege of experiencing their love in its highest form. Love is the strongest power there is. Love can change lives and make the world a better place. Marriage and family are the most significant bonds in our lives. I ask all of you present, are you willing now and always to encourage and strengthen this marriage by upholding both Jackie and Matt with your continual love and support in the years to come? If so, please respond by saying, we will.
We will.
We would like to take a moment to recognize those that could not be here today. While they may not physically be with us, Jackie and Matt feel their love and support. They will each place a rose they have created on reserve seats to commemorate their grandfathers and their presence with us today. Marriage is a very special spiritual connection of two people united for a common purpose, bringing love and trust together into single focus. We have come together in the presence of love to witness and bless the joining of this man and woman in matrimony. Marriage is not to be entered into lightly, but reverently and deliberately. Into this union, Jackie and Matt now come to be joined. Do you, Matt, accept Jackie as your true love and equal, promising to share in all that life offers, to be there for her in times of need, to soothe her in times of pain, to support her in all her endeavors, and to grow with her throughout the seasons of your life together?
I absolutely do.
Do you, Jackie, accept Matt as your true love and equal, promising to share in all that life offers, to be there for him in times of need, to soothe him in times of pain, to support him in all his endeavors, and to grow with him throughout the seasons of your life together?
Yes, I do.
A marriage is a home interwoven with hopes, memories, and dreams. From this day forward, you shall be each other's home, comfort, and refuge. Your marriage will be strengthened by mutual love and respect. Remember to be kind to one another. Strive to be gentle with criticism and generous with praise. Be empathetic and trusting. Allow yourselves to transcend your own limitations through the love you have for each other. A good marriage must be built on the foundation of this commitment. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you every day. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together and facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in thoughtful ways. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is the establishing of a relationship in which the independence is equal, the dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. When Jackie was little, her parents would read stories to her and her brother every night, and Jackie's father would create voices for the characters in each of the books. These nightly bedtime stories cultivated a love of reading in Jackie from an early age that has lasted into adulthood. Her father would often come to her school to read to her entire class, something she always cherished. Jackie has asked him to do the same for her one more time here today, to read to all of you an excerpt from The Velveteen Rabbit, a story Jackie loved as a child and that holds a great deal of meaning to her and Matt as adults.
What is real? Asked the rabbit one day. When they were lying side by side.
I can't hear you.
Can't hear me? Can you hear me?
I can hear now.
Okay. All right. Sorry, now it's going to be tougher for you because you're going to hear me. What is real? Okay, let me take this off. What is real? Asked the rabbit one day when they were lying side by side near the nursery fender before Nana came to tidy the room. Does it mean having things that buzz inside you and a stick out handle? Real isn't how it is made, said the skin horse. It's a thing that happens to you when a child loves you for a long, long time, not just to play with, but really loves you, then you become real. Does it hurt? Asked the rabbit. Sometimes. When you are real, you don't mind being hurt. Does it happen all at once? Like being wound up, or bit by bit? It doesn't happen all at once, said the skin horse. You become. It takes a long time. That's why it doesn't happen often to people who break easily or have sharp edges, who have to be carefully kept. Generally, by the time you are real,
Most of your hair has been loved off, and your eyes drop out, and you get loose in your joints and very shabby. But these things don't matter at all, because once you are real, you can't be ugly, except to people who don't understand. Matt's sister Rachel would also like to reflect on the early years together.
Thank you, Dad.
My pleasure.
Rachel.
Sorry. Can you hear me?
I'm going to scoot.
For those that don't know, Matt and Jackie are big movie buffs. Growing up, Matt and I both shared a love of movies, which created a strong bond between us. Our earliest memory of this bond started with us recreating the "we slept in" panic moment scene from the movie Home Alone, as the McAllister family rushed to get to their luggage together to make it to their Christmas vacation flight on time. The first time we reenacted this scene for our parents, we did multiple takes until we felt like we got it perfect. In honor of the love from movies that was cultivated in him at such a young age, Matt has asked me to read a brief quote from Sleepless in Seattle, a movie we both enjoyed growing up, and which speaks to Matt's feelings about Jackie when they first began dating. She asks Tom Hanks what is so special about his wife. He says, "Well, it was a million tiny little things that when you added them all up, it just meant we were supposed to be together." And I knew it. I knew it the very first time I touched her. It was like coming home, only to no home I'd ever known. I was just taking her hand to help her out of a car, and I knew it. It was like magic.
Thank you. At this time, Matt and Jackie would like to share their own vows of love and commitment to each other. Jackie, you go first.
Okay. Tell me if you can't hear me.
You're fine.
You can't hear me. Thank you. So I'm going to yell. I'm not yelling at you. Okay. Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Matt, my love, the first day I met you, I knew I would fall in love with you. It hit me like lightning. Your smile lit up Starbucks and continues to light my world every day. I'd never known what it meant to be loved completely for who I am until I met you. You love me at my silliest and my most serious. When I'm fired up at Verizon, dancing in our kitchen, or quietly reading a book, you are the love of my life and my best friend. You laugh, dance, and sing with me, and you even speak in movie quotes with me. You listen without judgment and are always thoughtful and kind. I love your passion and your enthusiasm, especially for the people in your life. And I am so grateful that you have chosen me to be your person, your love, and your partner. I love how patient, loving, and gentle you are. You inspire me to be open, try new things, and to step outside of my comfort zone. I love how joyful you are, and that you laugh loudly with your whole body. I love how excited you get whenever someone makes a reference to one of your favorite movies, and that whenever you put your mind to it, you can accomplish anything. I love how creative you are, and that the many ways you channel that creativity. I love the way you think. and your way of seeing the world. Your enthusiasm and joy for life are beautiful and rare. I love the person you are, and that everyone in your life is better for knowing you, especially me. You are one in a Googleplex. I was taught growing up to never make a promise unless I can keep it. Standing here today, I make these promises to you, knowing I intend to keep them for our whole lives. I promise to be honest, trustworthy, and faithful, and never to keep secrets, unless it's a surprise party. I promise to support, love, and care for you, even when you have a man cold while I have bronchitis and somehow yours is more debilitating. I promise to encourage, support, and believe in you, and to be your biggest fan, to walk beside you as your partner and teammate, and to remember when we struggle that it's never me against you, but us against the problem. I promise to put you first as my top priority and never to take you for granted, to be grateful for you daily, and to show you that gratitude often. I promise not to take life too seriously and to try and go with the flow a little more. I promise to love myself as much as I love you and to not depend upon you for my happiness, to know that no one can fill from an empty cup, and to remember to refill mine and try and help you refill yours. I promise to give you the best of myself and to encourage you to be your best self. I will also give you all of my pickles. I promise to never judge you and to always give you the benefit of the doubt and to treat you with kindness and respect, to stand beside you as your partner through all life has in store for us, to enjoy each moment of the good times, and to work with you to overcome the bad. I promise to fight for us if and when things get hard, to listen, to be open and communicate with you, and to be careful with my words. I will be a safe space for you, your worries, secrets, and anxieties. I promise to travel the world with you and also happily stay in bed for an entire day watching Back to the Future and eating goodies. I promise to spend my life showing you the amazing person that you are, especially when you may forget. Above all else, I promise to love you completely as you are in each moment, and to show you that love in all the ways you need. I love you and I like you, Matt Grove. Let's go have a great life.
Jackie, the first time I saw you, I will never forget my reaction because of how unique my internal feelings were to seeing you and hearing you for the first time. In addition to be taken with how beautiful you were, I was drawn to how confident, collected...
Oh,
speak up. Oh.
Sorry.
It's this mic. Oh, it's mine?
That mic.
Oh, that mic. I'm speaking of that mic?
I guess.
There you go.
Let's do that.
In addition to be taken with how beautiful you were, I was drawn to how confident, collected, and just how well you carried yourself. At that point, my first thought came to me, and I heard my inner self say, I better not mess this up. At that point in my life, I was so caught up in my own inner thoughts and feelings that it had caused me to wade through a long period of self-doubt about who I was and the things that I enjoyed doing. Going into our first date, this had me worried that I might do something or say something that would almost immediately turn you away, such as revealing something personal where I might get a response like, wait, you actually built a full-size Ghostbusters proton pack just for fun. But you blindsided me once we began talking about our own DIY projects when you casually worked into the conversation that one of the wooden directional signs that you had been working on was a Back to the Future Hill Valley sign. My worried inner thoughts about scaring you off instantly went away. What I began to realize were that the aspects of myself that I enjoyed, that I thought would have easily turned you away, would make for the most fun, enjoyable, and longest first date I would ever go on. And in turn, it would make for the most special relationship I will ever have. I had never connected with someone so well and so quickly. We learned that our DIY projects were something that we held very closely to us, and so we continued sharing with each other all of the projects we love creating the most. We discussed our very closely matched movie interests and talked about our desire to one day have a movie room of our own. We both shared how we loved to explore that fun side of ourselves and how much we enjoyed spending time by ourselves, getting caught up in the activities that we enjoyed, ones that we would soon enjoy doing together as a couple. Short story about our first date. One of the things that I had learned about Jackie that day, I had learned after asking if she needed to leave early to go home and celebrate with her family. Since our first date had landed on the Easter Sunday, I was secretly hoping she'd say no so that we could stay out together a little longer. She looked at me and smiled and said, "No, we don't celebrate that." Innocently, I was like, "Oh, you don't?" She's still smiling. She looked at me and said, "No." I said, "Oh, why not?" She goes, "I'm Jewish." I smiled and said, "Oh, wow." That made me happy because that meant we didn't have to cut our date any shorter than we wanted. After our date and for the rest of the evening, I happily reminisced about every detail that happened, but there was one detail that was concerning me about my possible future with this lovely person. So, to quiet my concern, I enlisted my most reliable source, Google. I had been raised Catholic, so learning that Jackie was Jewish made me worry that there may not be a future for us. So, I typed in my blunt question into Google. Can Jewish and Catholic people get married? To my discovery and relief, I found that yes, it was possible to have a ceremony with two people from different walks of life. And we're proof of that now. Jackie, there are so many big and little things that I love about our relationship that have not lessened since I first met you. For one, I still love picking up your leftover popcorn. I know that you said that this is something that I'll get annoyed about, but I won't. Because the remnants of a fun night that was had recently, and it makes me reminisce about it, and it prompts me to look forward to the next fun night we have together. I love everything about how sweetly you peruse the bookshelves in Barnes & Noble whenever we stop in to look around. And I love just standing back and watching how excitedly you bounce from one bookshelf to another. It's your happy place, and I will always love seeing you in your happy place. I love that you're always helping me and teaching me how I can get that perfect shot that I always try to get when we're out on one of our photo hikes. You are a beautiful photographer, and I love learning from you. I can't wait to go on our next one, by the way. I love how much you care. I love how much care you take with the people who are close to you. I remember the first time you ever sent me something in the mail to brighten my mood, which was fairly early into our relationship. It was after the first flood had happened in Ellicott City, which had been a special place for me and had recently become a special place for us. It was one of the first times you had ever seen me at my lowest, so you sent me the one thing you knew would put a smile on my face at a time like that. A miniature Back to the Future hoverboard to add to my never-ending collection of Back to the Future memorabilia, which is out of my memorabilia now. Most people might not understand the significance of this, but you knew how much it would mean to me. It was one of the first times that I had got to see how beautiful and big of a heart you had when the people you love are not in their brightest of times. It offered just a glimpse into how big of a heart you have. I had no idea I could be this happy. You show me a place of happiness that I have never experienced to the point where I even asked you on our first official date, are you sure you're real? Which has since evolved to, who are you? Which we ask each other consistently. I can't believe you're real. We celebrate so much of what we love to do in common, it's almost impossible to comprehend. How lucky.
Just for you.
He's late.
It's almost impossible to comprehend how lucky we were to have found each other. We're DIYers, we're party planners, we're planners, period. We work out together, we travel together, we sing together, especially in the car. Mm-hmm. We dance together, we're both photographers. We enjoy doing everything together. We enjoy doing absolutely nothing together. You've helped me realize that not only is it okay to be the person that I am, but that it's okay to be all the person all the time. Jackie, there is so much I love about our relationship. So to begin our future as Team Grove, I want you to hear from me the vows that I want to make for our relationship to continue being the strong and happy and rewarding bond that it is. I vow to always be your partner, whether it's quietly being there to listen to you talk through any of your difficult experiences, or whether it's cheering you on as your biggest cheerleader during your best moments. I promise to listen closely to you after I've done something wrong, to make you upset, recognize my faults, and in some cases, try not to take it too personally, and to instead try to look at it as a point of growth so that we can make our relationship stronger. I vow to resist the temptation to rush into finding a solution to a problem that you're having, regardless of it's whether it's something I feel I can fix. It's not about the nail. I will try my best to see the forest through the trees and not get in my own way, and to see the bigger picture when I get inside of my own head. I promise to continue to be open to discovering new ways that we can spend time together. I love that we still have a few date night questions that we can still use for this. I vow to honor every request you make for me to sing Billy Joel to you while we're in the car together, because I love singing to you. I promise that when we watch Back to the Future together, I will know that we are going to be watching all three movies, because like you said, it's all one movie. You certainly do not need to twist my arm there. Finally, since I know that healthy relationships grow and change, I promise to consistently tend to these vows to make sure that they grow with us and reflect the relationship that we're continuing to build together. One more thing I want to recognize about you is your carefree attitude, which I value so much. It's a quality of yours that I find myself constantly being drawn to and inspires me to want to live my life just as freely as you live yours every day. Whenever we get ready to spend a day out together and there's a threat of rain, I'll ask if we should grab an umbrella while we walk around together. I love that many of those times you'll smile and say, no. And say to me a phrase that has stayed with us since our first date. Whenever you say that, I instantly relax and I'm reminded to just let it be and to let things happen as they happen. So whatever comes our way, I will embody that same carefree phrase and outlook you share with me on our first date after we started walking into Ellicott City and it started to rain. So we'll get wet.
Alex, may I have the rings, please? Having love in your hearts for one another, you have chosen to exchange rings as the sign and seal of the promises you're making to one another today. From the earliest times, the circle has been a symbol of completeness and a symbol of committed love. An unbroken and never-ending circle symbolizes a commitment of love that is also never-ending. These rings are a symbol of the unity into which your two lives are now joined. May these two rings symbolize the spirit of undying love in each of your hearts. Matt, as a sign of your faithfulness, place the ring on Jackie's finger and repeat after me. Jackie, I marry you.
Jackie, I marry you.
With all that I have.
With all that I have.
And all that I am.
and all that I am.
Please wear this ring.
Please wear this ring.
And the world will know.
And the world will know.
I am yours and you are mine.
I am yours and you are mine.
And that's it forever.
And that's it forever.
Jackie, as a sign of your faithfulness, place the ring on Matt's finger and repeat after me. Matt, I marry you.
Matt, I marry you.
With all that I have.
With all that I have.
And all that I am.
And all that I am.
Please wear this ring.
Please wear this ring.
And the world will know.
And the world will know.
I am yours and you are mine.
I am yours and you are mine.
And that's it forever.
And that's it forever.
Every marriage starts out as a blank canvas, and every day is a splash of color. This canvas represents the day of the wedding and a new beginning. Oh, what happened? It fell down.
Oops. Such is life. Well, let's go over there.
All right.
While you
read. Yeah, I'll read. The paint colors signify the experiences that lie ahead. Colors of joys and sorrows, blessings and heartaches. The colors represent Matt and Jackie's milestones, their celebrations, tribulations, passions, and dreams. They are the moments that become the days that make up the years. There will be places on the canvas where the colors blend and mix, flowing together, creating a new color of experiences shared. There will be places when the colors stay separate and stand out alone and independent, yet still a complement to the bold color by its side. And there may be places of contrast, parts of the canvas that look dark or messy and not at all to the couple's liking, and parts also left blank and bare. However, when you step back and look at the canvas in its entirety, you will see that it is clearly an original masterpiece, unlike anything you've ever seen before. Each color, contrast, and shadow blend as unique and beautiful as Matt and Jackie.
You don't have any more paint.
I don't. That's why I'm losing yours.
It's a good thing we did a dry run before the wedding, so we have one. Beep. It's gorgeous. It's gorgeous.
Uh-oh.
That would be great. Mom, I need more lipstick.
Matt, I only see purple.
It's all good.
Thanks,
that's
man.
Fine. I like purple. It's my favorite color. I know. But it's
thanks. Thanks. Oh, you're a mess.
We sweat. It's paint. What do you expect?
A tradition in Jewish culture that Matt and Jackie would like to honor here today is the breaking of the glass. This is a symbolic prayer and hope that your love for one another will remain until the pieces of the glass come together again, or in other words, that your love will last forever. The fragile nature of the glass also suggests the frailty of human relationships. Even the strongest of relationships is subject to disintegration. The glass, then, is broken to protect the marriage with this prayer. May your bond of love be as difficult to break as it would be to put the pieces of this glass together again. Right foot.
Right foot, right foot.
Oh, mazel tov! Yay! We ready?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Jackie and Matt, now that you have shared with each other words of love and commitment, and we have witnessed the expression of your love as you have given each other rings, and you have joined your hands and hearts before your family and friends, with the authority entrusted to me, it is with great joy that I pronounce you husband and wife. In the words of Doc Brown, your future is whatever you make it, so make it a good one. Matt, you may kiss your bride.
Oh, thank you.
Family and friends, it is my privilege to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Matt and Jackie Grove.